This is Max Olson with Adjuster TV. We're playing middle ground right now. We're not sure exactly what's going on with Dorian. It's a strong Category 4 hurricane right now, but the question is, where will it make landfall, if at all? So we're going to go ahead and take a look here at the newest model trends, see what we're thinking, and see what we're going to end up doing here.
All right, so we're going to make this short and sweet. There's not a whole lot to talk about because there's so much uncertainty, and we don't have anything factual to go off of other than what we see currently here on satellite, which is a very impressive Category 4, potentially approaching Category 5 storm, heading towards some of the islands of the Bahamas. It is a very impressive storm on satellite, that is no doubt. But what is uncertain is what happens near and after it is impacting those islands that you can see off here to the west. The general consensus has been an eastward shift as of the last, mostly this morning. However, now more recent model runs are showing a bit of a westward shift. All right, so let's just take a look here at one of the various computer models that is generating these different situations. We can see here earlier this morning, we have a hurricane that is well offshore, but if we look at the run that came out a few hours ago, it is much closer inland. And though it may not look like it, that is actually a relatively significant difference in all things considered. If we go here to another different computer model, we can see the storm actually appears to be making landfall in Florida, whereas a few hours prior, this model was showing it making landfall in South Carolina. What does this mean? It means nobody is exactly sure what's going to happen. There's so many variables going into these models, and the slightest difference could make a landfall happen or an out-to-sea solution happen. So we're just really not sure, and this is going to continue as we are still multiple days out from any potential landfall. The model variance is very high with this particular storm, and we're not in the Gulf of Mexico, right? It's not like it is surrounded by land. We just have the western side of the storm potentially impacting land. Some models show it impacting land the entire storm. Some models have it going out to sea. The basic premise here is we don't have a good grasp on exactly what is going to happen yet. As we get a little closer to the event, hopefully these models should start to consolidate on a particular solution, but that is never guaranteed. So, the most important thing to take from this, if you are stationed out here, if you have been called by any of the IA firms, don't start booking your plane back home yet, and don't expect to be staying out here forever. You just have to run with the solutions that are coming about, and it's pretty much going to be one of those situations where we don't know until it is maybe even hours away from landfall. It's a very dynamic situation. So the most important thing is to realize that we are in the peak of hurricane season. So now is the time, if any, to get any last minute training in. And if you're getting called out, just stay put and wait for this to happen, because we're not sure what's gonna happen. And if you're already there, there's no point in getting antsy by any means. Everybody, stay safe if you're on the East Coast. We're gonna be monitoring this. We're playing middle ground, like I said. We're not sure exactly where it's gonna go and what we're gonna do, but we will make sure to keep you informed here at Adjuster TV. Stay tuned to the Facebook page, the YouTube page. Go ahead and comment if you have any questions, and we will keep you updated as this situation evolves. Thanks, guys, and have a great night.